that there are now more food banks in the GTA than there are McDonald's. That's shocking and it's shameful. And we are now asking people on social assistance to rely on food banks, not only folk on social assistance, but the working poor, because the minimum wage, as we all know, is way below the poverty line. So people who are working on minimum wage also are using food banks. And as the woman's critic, as well as the housing critic, I want to say that poverty is a woman's issue. It's a children's issue. The vast majority of the poor who use food banks are women and children. And, by the way, there are far more of them poor and using food banks right now that need that extra supplement than there were under Harris. That's how shameful it is. That actually the welfare rates, the social assistance rates, have gone down in real terms, in real dollar terms, since the Harris years. So where is the shock? Where is the reaction? Where is the uproar? Where are the 1,000 people on the front lawns of Queen's Park? I'd like to know. You are to be absolutely applauded for making poverty an issue. You need to make that issue louder. And thank you, Anglicans. I'm a United Church minister myself, and I wish my denomination was out here as well. And I say to all the people of faith, thank you to the Anglicans, because you have made housing and you have made poverty an election issue, not only in this election coming up, but in the election in 2007. Thank you so much. So give the Anglicans a round of applause, because really you have absolutely led the charge on this issue. There's no question whatsoever. I'm wearing this garb because today is also the 55th anniversary of the Chinese occupation of Tibet, which is why you got booted away from the Queen's Park front lawns. But I can tell you on behalf of all my Tibetan brothers and sisters that they support you as well. And many Tibetans came here as refugees and were themselves using food banks. In fact, that's how I came to know Tibetans in my community, was that they helped run our local food bank. I also want to highlight Bonnie Briggs here, who has been at Put Food in the Diet Coalition in Parkdale High Park, phenomenal food activist. And what you see on the table here is what those on social assistance cannot afford to buy and eat. Certainly, if you can imagine living on just over $500 a month in Toronto, you know you're not eating healthy food. Hey, you're not eating at all. You're not paying rent. You're using food banks and you're sleeping in a shelter. And even those who are on disability support payments, ODSP, even those at around $1,000 a month cannot afford to buy this food. And these are folk who have a disability, who by definition cannot work. So where is the compassion and the ethicality and the morality in saying, if you're disabled, you should live in dire poverty. If you're disabled, you should not get enough to eat. That's what we're saying to them. That's shameful and that's shocking. And that's what we're all here to put a stop to this morning. So thank you so much for coming out despite the rain. They say when it rains, it's God crying tears. In this case, not of joy, but of sorrow. So keep up God's work. Thank you. And please make poverty an issue in the next election.